Students, welcome back to Chemistry is Easy for You. Today we are going to discuss the most important questions from periodic properties of elements. So periodic properties is a part of chemistry from which questions come for every exams, starting from plus 2 level up to the government exams in which chemistry questions are asked. Periodic properties are very, very important. So this is a common video for every exam, every chemistry exam. Objective type where the questions from periodic properties are asked. This is common for that, and definitely if we complete this series you can answer all questions from periodic properties. And before we begin with the questions, let me inform you all about the videos that we are going to do in June. We are going to start JEE 2020 classes at JAM. Also along with that we'll be doing all the other entrances for PG and UG level, the previous questions. And as far as JAM, JEE and CSA and NETGATE are concerned, we are going to do small topic videos, not very elaborate one, but smaller topic videos and topic wise previous questions. We will be doing that. In next video, I'll be informing more about that. But on June 1st itself, we are going to begin that. So please keep watching, everyone. Okay, then let's begin with the questions. So the first question is the size of ions change in the order. So the answer is option A, and the strategy that you have to use here is the number of electrons are same in all the four of these species. So once the electrons are the same, you will have to see the number of the nuclear charge. Okay, the nuclear charge you have to see. The nuclear charge will be higher. If the nuclear charge is higher, then the size will be decreasing because they will be pulling the electrons closer to it, and therefore the size will be decreasing. So when the number of electrons are equal, in that those cases the nuclear charge, when the species with lesser nuclear charge will be having higher size. Here Na plus is having lesser nuclear charge than Mg2 plus, than Si4 plus and Cl plus 7. Okay, now the second question: which has the highest electron affinity? The electron affinity usually decreases down the group, and you would be expecting fluorine to have the highest electron affinity, but the answer is chlorine, because fluorine is having lesser electron affinity than chlorine because of its small size, and a lot of electrons are present in it, and there would be repulsion between the existing electron, and therefore incoming electrons are not that welcome. Therefore there will be a reduction in the electron affinity compared to chlorine. Now the third question: in each period the most electropositive element belongs to the group. The answer is C. This doesn't require any explanation. This is very simple question. Most electropositive element would be in the first group, and the electropositivity would be decreasing across the down the group. The electropositivity would be decreasing. The electropositivity will be decreasing across the period, not the group, but the period. Across the period, the electropositivity will be decreasing from left to right. Please keep that in mind. Now we'll be having the fourth question. The fourth question is: which of the following is the strongest oxidizing agent? So the strongest oxidizing agent means it will be getting reduced quickly. So the strongest oxidizing agent would be F2. Just keep that in mind. It is something that you have to learn by heart, because this is a repeated question for all the exams, including the, as I said, the government exams. Now the fifth question is: the least polarized anion is. The least polarized anion would be option D, ClO4-. And the reason is that chlorine and nitrogen will have electronegativity closer to hydrogen. So there will be least charge separation. According to the polarizability or the polarized anion, the power we are expressing according to the charge separation. Here in nitrogen and chlorine, both the charge separation will be lesser. But in case of ClO4, the charge is distributed or shared among four oxygen than three in nitrogen. And therefore, this sharing among four will be decreasing. Again, so the least polarized anion would be ClO4-. Now the sixth question: the hydrogen halide with the highest percentage of ionic character is. It would be option D, HF. It is because compared to chlorine, bromine and iron, Fluorine is having the highest electronegativity compared to chlorine, bromine and iodine, and as a result HF will be having the highest percentage of ionic character. Now the next question is, the solubility of a salt in water depends on its lattice energy only, hydration energy only, both lattice and hydration energy, none of the above. It is both lattice and hydration energy. Hydration energy is the energy liberated when something is dissolved in water. If hydration energy is greater than lattice energy, then soluble, then the substance would be soluble. So hydration energy and lattice energy both are very important for expressing the solubility of a salt in water. Eighth question is, which of the following hydrides is most stable? The answer is option D, CH4. The reason is bond length. That is, due to the smaller size of carbon, the bond length will be smaller than in all the other compounds, all the other hydrides given. So stronger the bond means less bond length, stronger bond, and if stronger bond means obviously it would be a more stable hydride. So that is the reason, and option D, CH4, is the answer. Now the ninth question is, the radius of F minus O, O2 minus are in the order of. So if there are more number of electrons, definitely the radius will be increasing. So O2 minus and F minus are definitely having more radius than O and F. And also across the, we know that from left to right across the period, the radii decreases across the period. So definitely what would happen, since O2 minus and F minus are isoelectronic, again O2 minus would be greater than F minus, those would be greater than the neutral species O and F. So the reason is two reasons. One is that the radii will be decreasing across the period from left to right, and the second reason is that O2 minus and F minus are having more electrons than the neutral species, and therefore their radii will be more than the neutral species. Now the next question, the 10th question is, which one of the following has maximum value of hydrated radii? So Li plus. It is because smaller the size, small size, easier, the more will be hydration, more hydration, and therefore more hydrated radii. So Li plus is the answer for that question. So the next question is, which one of the following is the strongest base? And the strongest base would be NH3 among these. It is because smallest N becoming the small, compared to these, N is the smallest, and therefore it can give up electron easily. So what does base do? Base would give up the electrons easily, and therefore due to the smaller size nitrogen, it would be easier to give up the electrons, and therefore that is the strongest base among all the others. Now the next question is, the order of first ionization energy of the elements lithium, beryllium, boron and sodium is? The answer is option D, beryllium greater than boron greater than lithium greater than Na. We can, you already know the reason, and I will show you the theoretical value, the experimental values as well of the ionization, first ionization energy. 9.3 for beryllium, 8.3 for boron, 5.4 for lithium and 5.1 for sodium. So that itself is the order of the first ionization order of elements lithium, beryllium, boron and sodium. Now the 13th question is, the statement that is not correct for periodic classification of elements is? So in these kinds of questions, carefully go through the sentences and understand the meaning, and then connect it with the facts that you already know. So the first sentence is, the properties of elements are a periodic function of atomic number. It is correct statement. Non-metallic elements are less than metallic elements in number. It is also correct. Then C, the first ionization energy does not vary in a regular manner across the period. So that is also correct. There is a variation in the first ionization. It do not increase or decrease according to the atomic number. There would be variation when there are half-filled or full-filled configuration and so on. So definitely that is correct. Then fourth option is, for transition elements, D subshells are filled monotonically according to atomic number. So that is, the meaning of that sentence is, they are regularly filled The D subshell would be regularly filled according to the atomic number. But that is wrong statement, and that is the statement that we are looking for in the question. That is, which is not correct. In D subshells, we can see that up to, that is, scandium, titanium, vanadium, they will be filled as such. Then chromium, due to its half-filled stability, it will be D5 instead of D4, and therefore we can say that the transition elements D subshells are not filled in the regular manner. It is having changes. So the 14th question is, covalent radius of nitrogen is 70 pm, hence the covalent radius of boron is about. So this is not a thing that you have to study by heart, you just have to connect and study. The answer would be option D, 110 ppm. Why? Because the radius of nitrogen is given as 70 ppm, and we know that from left to right, there should be the atomic or the covalent radius should decrease. Therefore, boron should definitely have a value of covalent radius more than that of nitrogen. That is, it should be greater than 70. Here only one option is having greater than 70, which is 110. Therefore, that would be the answer. Now, the metal which gives no amphoteric oxide is, it is option B, copper. This is something you have to learn. We don't need any explanation, because amphoteric means can both be acidic nature and basic nature. And copper does not show such a, the oxide of copper does not show such a behavior. Now, the next question is, the heat of hydration of Ca2 plus, Sr2 plus and Ba2 plus in decreasing in the order. It is decreasing in the order Ca2 plus greater than Ba2 plus greater than Sr2 plus. This is according to the size. It would be easier, the heat of as the size increases, the heat of hydration would be decreasing, and that is exactly the trend that we are seeing in this particular sequence. Next question is, electronegativity of the element A is E1 and the ionization potential is E2, hence the electron affinity would be. So let's see, the electronegativity can be given as ionization potential plus electron affinity divided by 2, or according to this particular question, it should be E1 is equal to Ea plus E2 by 2, or we can write as electron affinity is equal to 2E1 minus E2. So option A would be the right answer. This was one of the question in IIT JEE exam. So these kinds of questions, you have to just remember the electronegativity different scales and the formulas. And one of the formula is like this. The electronegativity is ionization potential plus electron affinity divided by 2. And we are just giving the notation given in the questions and rewriting it to find the answer. Now the 18th question is, the correct order of third ionization enthalpy of sodium, magnesium and aluminium is. So what is the third ionization enthalpy means? That is, to remove the third electron. So in aluminium, if we remove the third electron, it would get the stable noble gas configuration, and therefore definitely the third ionization energy of aluminium would be the least, because it would be very easy to remove so as to get a stable electronic configuration. What about magnesium? Magnesium, if we remove two electrons, it already attained the stable electronic configuration. So removing one more electron would be disturbing the stability, and therefore that would be the maximum. Now we don't even have to think about sodium. The order would be Mg greater than Na greater than aluminium. That is, Mg is already having a stable electronic configuration, noble gas configuration after removing the second electron, and therefore the third ionization energy would be maximum. And for aluminium, it would be least, because removing a third electron would give it the noble gas configuration. So that is the reason. Now we'll go to the next question. 19. The first ionization potential of sodium is 5.1 electron volt. The value of the electron gain enthalpy of Na plus would be. So the answer is option B, because the value of electron gain enthalpy, I will write it as EG, electron gain enthalpy would be negative of or the reverse of ionization potential of the parent atom. That is, Na gives Na plus plus electron. So the ionization potential to do this and the electron gain enthalpy, which is in the reverse direction, would have the opposite sign. Since one is 5.1, the other should definitely be minus 5.1. So that is the answer here. Now the final question is, which of the following elements can exhibit covalency of greater than 4? This is something that you have to keep in your mind. The answer is option C, chlorine, and chlorine can extend its covalency up to 7. Okay, it is because of availability of empty d orbitals, it can extend its covalency up to 7. And we'll be discussing more questions from this part in the coming videos. This is very important for, as I said in the beginning, this is very important for all the exams, this portion. It is very simple, so what we should do is cover maximum number of questions to ensure that we have the basics strong. That's all. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe our channel, hit the bell icon for latest notification, and as I said in the beginning again, please continue with us for all the videos that we are starting from June. That is for everyone, UG, PG level, plus 2 level, and even for the government exam, we are starting all those from starting from June 1st. So thank you so much.